Ground's not polluted there, is it? I think you're having a fib, mate, to be honest. Well, hello, Bob Dendry here, and welcome back to City Skylines, where we are building the town of Lorikeet Valley. So, last episode we spent a lot of time working on this terrible traffic situation we have in Lorini. Now, I've been working on this before I started recording for actually about an hour or so, so... yeah, I mean, it seems to be better than it is, but it's very cyclical. If we look down our motorway, or our highway, you know, traffic is backing up so much at the moment. It does sort of pull back quite a bit to, you know, here, where we go down to two lanes from time to time, but then it will sort of jump back up. But overall, it looks like we're probably heading in the right direction. There's maybe a few sort of problems, or I guess solutions really, to the situation here we could potentially look at in terms of a bit more public transport. Now, first thing I want to do is, we've got this new train station here. It's a lot of people waiting there, but I think we want more. We do have our bus rapid transit, which is actually acting a little bit as a feeder to our train station there, which is good news, but I think we could do a little bit better. We could set this up as a bit of a park and ride facility to potentially get more people onto this train and less people, you know, sitting in their cars on the motorway. So first things first, we are going to need to pull out some of the houses that we built only last episode. I do apologize to all of these people. It wasn't my intention to do this, but it's what we need for, I guess, the good of the community, shall we say. Instead, so we're going to, I guess, take Paradise and put up a parking lot, as you could potentially describe it as. So what we're going to do, we're going to run with some big parking lots here, I think. So I'm going to... get down a little bit of a parking lot, which we'll put in this area here. If I'm not mistaken, you should put these down in multiples of three. We might take off our road guidelines because they're giving us a bit of grief, and just stay on angle. Possibly grid as well. Perfect. That's not perfect, actually. but it's... I think it'll do okay. Got a little hump there. So we might need to just level everything out. So we'll make everything... no, not two terrain height. My mistake. I wanted object height. So that should keep everything nice and even. Might need to do some clipping or fix up with some clipping. A lot of people are using this to turn around, which is interesting. So we'll get a couple of drive roads in here. Maybe one right here. And we might put one perhaps... over here, which is stuffed with our little turnaround spot a little bit. So I think we'll need to just reinsert a node there. Perfect. Now I've got a lot of cars using it to turn around, which is not ideal, but yeah. All right, so... let's get a filler in here, and if I'm right, this should be Maybe. Yeah, I think that works well. Already got people parking. And where are they going? Going to the library. Well, I mean, I guess it's a sort of public amenity. People can do what they need to do there, I suppose. And we might get some disabled parking as well, actually. But we'll I'll lay out the rest of this. And what I might do, in fact. Is we'll make maybe a fair whack of this disabled. Alright, there we've got a decent-sized car park, and it is getting a lot of use. I wonder what everyone is doing. Looks like potentially we're getting some public transport use. That is actually really good to see. We'll just need to do a little bit of clipping remover. Pop there and there. And yeah, that's, hopefully... What are you doing here? I don't want you. Oh, okay, bye. Oh, yes, I forgot about this. The allow intercity trains. That is going to cause problems for us. I'm sure it'll be fine. All right, so while I've been doing that, let's see how the city's going. The same, if not worse. Fantastic. I feel like there's not a heap wrong with the traffic in the city at this point. It's functioning more or less as required, so really, it's probably this point here that is really causing a massive issue, because that's where, you know, you've got three sort of major movements, both directions on the motorway and, well, four really, and both directions on Birdsong Boulevard. So there might be... might be maybe some issues where we've perhaps not quite planned properly. One thing I'm considering doing, which I think I might actually do, is putting in a bit of a relief road, I should say, through to Lafayette Hills, and we'll ban cargo traffic on the road as well. So that will give residents and maybe travellers... you know, a bit of a shortcut. People probably wouldn't be happy about it. But at least the sort of heavy freight traffic isn't going to be using it. So I've built that connection there, quick and nasty, bit gross. We can probably lower it a tiny bit. Probably what we could actually do is lower that and lift that a little bit. And so straight away we're just going to put some vehicle restrictions on, which is going to be no trucks. Free game for everything else. Let's have a look and see has that made any sort of a difference? Is that going to start generating routes? A couple, but not too bad. Here we go. We are starting to see. It looks like it's mostly local movements. That is actually really good because that is stopping people from having to use a city link road to get to and from home, to get to work. And hopefully it remains that way and we don't see too many sort of movements where they're cutting across the link road and coming through Lafayette Hills. But it's a pretty unattractive movement anyway. You have to sort of drive all the way in and then hook around. So I would expect we won't see too many of those movements. We are seeing some movement here though, with people who are perhaps going, you know, quite a way away and maybe coming into work or visit a friend or something like that. So that's okay. I'm pretty happy with that. I'm not minding it too much either. Okay, so yeah, I mean, this is popular. Look at this. Wow. I wasn't expecting this much use of that car park, otherwise it would have made it a bit bigger. But that's actually probably good for us. It means that this is a movement that people are wanting to do. And we can also see that our bus rapid transit is being used as a bit of a park and ride as well. That is probably not so much what we want to have happening. So we might potentially try and dissuade that. Well, what I'm considering maybe doing is, well, first of all, let's have a look and see what stop are people actually using here. Where is the bus rapid transit? Before we make this judgment that that's what they're using it for, we should actually confirm our hypothesis. We've got the M1. And 124. Yeah, so the 124 is our last stop. So yes, they are using it as a park and ride. So what I'm considering doing in that case is removing this from our M1 stop and having the M1 stop just go from perhaps just Green Hills, or we maybe might put a stop a little bit further up into Banksia Hills. And instead, we would actually run a park and ride bus. Oh, sorry, a shuttle bus, specifically from maybe a few sort of areas to our bus station. We might even consider putting a bus stop over here so people can potentially use this as a park and ride. We would say that because, you know, we've got such terrible traffic congestion issues, the council and the owner of this shopping centre have put their heads together and decided that they will offer that as maybe a temporary measure. So let's have a look and see what options we've got then. So first of all, this is gone. And I will... see, that's what our issue is with doing that, is that now it wants to run through the city. Is there anything we could do to force a movement here? Yes, we would need to add a stop back at the Hope Anchor Centre, but that's okay. That's fine. Small price to pay. And what I'm thinking we may do is perhaps run a bus from maybe Hilltop Park via Green Hills, via our shopping center, and to the train station, and use that as our park and ride. So we'll call that P1. I hate when this happens. let's try that one again. Try that V P1 Waratah Park and Ride. And what vehicles do we want to use? I feel like we may have a park and ride bus. Well, let's have a look. I'm going to remove all these vehicles and we'll select a time. Yeah, so we've got, it's a little small bus. Anything else? Let's try the little small bus and see if that's overwhelmed or not. Where was it? I've lost it. Park and ride. Let's try. We'll add maybe 5. And we'll just let it run for a little while and see what sort of usage we're getting. This stop, I'm guessing, is the station. No, this stop is actually Green Hills. I suppose they're the people who are using our old M1 service. They're now switching across to utilize our park and ride. So that's okay. I've got a few people waiting at the station as well. What I want to do, I want to just allow a U-turn at this intersection. And just allow our buses to go, you know, do a quick UE rather than having to drive through the car park. So allow a U-turn there. And hopefully that will be utilized. Okay, so I've made a decision. It's not one I'm particularly proud of, but it's one that I needed to make for the good of this playthrough, and I have turned on despawning. Yes, sad, very sad, but hopefully we can still have a lot of fun with this game while being somewhat realistic with traffic. To be honest, I've never stuffed up a game this bad. So this is, you know, the definition of embarrassment for me. But hopefully we will be able to recover. Our population has pushed back up to above 30,000, which is good. It had fallen down, you know, as low as like 25, because people were just abandoning their homes due to, you know, dead bodies being not picked up, due to all sorts of stuff, garbage not being picked up. So hopefully despawning will give us a bit of a second lease on life in terms of making all of this work. Okay, so I've made a decision. It's not one I'm particularly proud of, but it's one that I needed to make for the good of this playthrough, and I have turned on despawning. Yes, sad, very sad, but hopefully we can still have a lot of fun with this game while being somewhat realistic with traffic. To be honest, I've never stuffed up a game this bad. So this is, you know, the definition of embarrassment for me. But hopefully we will be able to recover. Our population has pushed back up to above 30,000, which is good. It had fallen down, you know, as low as like 25, because people were just abandoning their homes due to, you know, dead bodies being not picked up, due to all sorts of stuff, garbage not being picked up. So hopefully despawning will give us a bit of a second lease on life in terms of making all of this work. That doesn't make it any less sad, by the way, because I do love playing with despawning turned off. But I've made quite a few changes to the city, as you can see. Put a little tunnel in here so that people coming from the Link Road can access the, I guess from this point of view, the south side of the city without conflicting with any other sort of movements coming in from our SPUI. Also put in a slip lane here, put dedicated turning lanes in pretty much wherever, you know, I literally could So hopefully we can actually move on from this now and do some actual city building and city planning. Fingers crossed anyway. So I guess that brings us to what is next. So we do have still a little bit of developable land on the other side of our, of what is this street called these days? I don't know what it's called. Price Avenue. We do have a little bit of developable land and we could potentially flatten this block out a little bit, which I'm going to do now. So we'll probably get the height of our road and just push that back a little bit towards Garnet. I want to try and push it sort of as far back as we can go without getting nasty cliff textures like we've got there. So what I'm going to do, I think, is we'll push it out all the way. And then I will use the smoothing tool to sort of drag those back. Might just drag that height a little bit as well. Okay, perfect. And we got, yeah, nice little bit of land we can use here. Whoops. We can sort of grid that up, which I might pretty much do off the bat. And then we can make some connections to our main road and all of that. So it should be fun. Okay, we've got two entries. We also have an opportunity here, which we might use this road here for, to set up a second entrance to the Garnet area to, I guess, give a little bit of redundancy there. It won't be a collector grade road. It will be a wide road, but it's just going to be one of our 1+1 wide roads. From there, I'm just going to work on some, hopefully some interesting sort of grid patterns. I don't want this to be just a standard grid. Hopefully we can do something a little bit special or a little bit different with it. Okay, so this is going to be our new neighborhood here. It's looking a little bit different. We might ban... We do have trucks using this road now, which, yeah, actually, I'm okay with it. As long as they're not, like, cutting all the way through the neighborhood, I think it's fine. We're going to have a bit of sort of unused space here, which we'll use for some decoration. We might get a nice park in potentially around about this area, where we've got a fair few trees sitting. But it's time to get our water pipes laid, and then we'll go from there. Alright, so we're going to reserve this block here for a bit of a park area. The rest we will set up with primarily low density residential. In fact, what we might do, we might get a little bit of higher density on this little corner here. So we might hand place a few little apartment buildings, stuff like that. But yeah, we obviously have got a fair bit of residential demand right now, as we can see. And let's get down a neighborhood here as well. Let's call this one Homebush. Okay, what I might do here is just put down a little small sort of park area. I've forgotten how to do life right now. We'll call this Homebush Park. Yeah, this is going to be a little, just a little city park type area. So we'll get probably just a small main gate and a few side gates around the place. And just get a couple of bits and pieces about to make things a little bit interesting for our residents here. I might move that onto the other side of this road if it'll fit. Yeah, not too bad. And then we'll get our chessboard over this side. A little bit of a cafe. Of course, restrooms. Everyone in Garnet's really happy. Ooh, what's happening here? Residents are sick. The ground is polluted. Why is the ground polluted here? What? Why would that be the case? Ground's not polluted there, is it? I think you're having a fib, mate, to be honest. Ground looks perfectly fine. I think we'll just put this down on zero. We're not going to actually charge people to get in here. And I'm just going to lay down some greenery and some trees around the place. All right, we just got a nice little basic park down. I don't think we've got any use as of yet. I'm actually thinking we're going to change the name of this park from Homebush Park. So we've placed a lot of these delphiniums around the place. So we might call it Delphinium Park. If we have a look at the neighborhood, it's slowly developing. Not massively fast, so many fire helicopters around the place, though. Where are they going? They're going to fill up over here. Okay, that makes sense. Yeah, with the population revisited mod, I do tend to notice that your demand will seem like massively high and then it'll drop straight down as soon as you place some zoning down. So I'm not sure if that's intended, because it doesn't, like when I see like a full demand, I'm like, you know, crap, like we've got people homeless in the streets. But it doesn't quite work out that way, I don't think. But how's our city going anyway? So traffic over here is heavy, but it is more or less working. One thing I obviously am challenged by, one issue I'm having really is that this is a really short node, which is causing some cars not to stop at the lights. What I could potentially do is reduce the speed limit, but I don't know if that is going to be the best solution. I'm sure it's fine in any case. So yeah, things are looking a little bit better now, of course, now that we've, you know, turned on easy mode. And that is probably going to be about it for this episode, though it's probably been a fairly short episode for you, to be honest, but for me this has actually been a really long episode, because I have been spending a lot of time just trying to fix the traffic, sort of recording it, but it's probably not going to actually make it into the episode, maybe like a short montage or something like that. But I hope you've enjoyed the video. If you have, please give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and ring that notification bell so you get a ding to your device the next time I post a video. You can find links to all my social media in the description, so please jump on there, like, follow, subscribe, do all that wonderful stuff. There is also a link to my Discord, so if you want to join the conversation about the content or anything else for that matter, hop on there and I'm happy to have a chat. Also find a link to my Buy Me A Coffee should you want to give something a little bit financial to the channel. But until next time, I'm Bob Dendry. This is City Skylines. Thank you so much for watching, and goodbye.